Intersect, a function that computes the first intersection of a ray with geometry. This will give you the first collision only. If you want to get all, use intersect all. This is the VEX alternative to the RaySop, and I use it often if I do multiple tasks in one wrangle that depend on the result of that intersect. I do a quick comparison with the RaySop at the end, and you will see why I stick to VEX. So, where would you use this? For example, when making the rail system, I used this to test the distance to the surface to determine which tower or bridge to place. But here's a simple example of what you can do with this function in Houdini. An intersection test is basically a ray shooting out from somewhere, hitting or not hitting something, and you can do something with that information. So if we start with a box and get rid of some faces, we can build a test scenario around shooting a ray from the one side to the other. But this is more interesting if we have a number of these boxes with different length. For that, I take a line with an attribute giving each point a different width value. Then in a for each loop, I copy the box onto each point but reference the width attribute on the box. Now we have a setup to use the intersect function, but we need an origin. If I look at one box, I can see that the face at the starting point is primitive number 1. So I isolate that prim and replace it with a point at its center. Being too lazy to type, I use my VEX library to grab the code for that. I gather the points in a group I called marker. And with that, we have a somewhat useful use case. The task is, find me the distance to the other side and set a color to the prim at the end. Do something that visualizes the distance. Doesn't sound like much, but it is a task you might encounter more often than you think. So the function expects an origin, a direction, and then two vector variables where it can write some information to. Let's call those pos for position and uv, because that's what it used for. A very important gimmick of this function is that it returns the primitive number it hit. Let's take that with us, and the ray is starting at the origin and going into a given direction. Once a hit occurs, the hit position is saved in that pos variable. That allows us to do something with it, like getting a distance between the current position and the hit. Then we can fit that value to have a range between 0 and 1. Useful when using a ramp. If we grab a color from a ramp using the distance value, we can set the primitive that got hit by the ray to that specific color. The origin is the marker point, so at P. The direction in this setup is a value in the X direction for whatever width we used before, plus 1 just for good measure. Now we can use it to color the primitive between green while having a distance of 0 or red at the max distance. Here's the pitfall when using the function. At first, this doesn't seem to work, but it does. The marker sits right on top of its own origin primitive, so the intersect will collide immediately with it. That's important to know. A simple fix is to give that starting position a little nudge into the direction you want to test. This looks much cleaner if we use variables, but who has the time? With all of that in place, you can build upon this into different directions. The result of the intersect can determine the next steps, or you can dynamically influence the incoming data by, let's say, an audio file coming in from a CHOP network, while the setup will dynamically adapt to that data. Regardless of how far you blow up the original proportion of your setup, and finally, a look at the SOP node that you can use to work your way around VEX. If you use the RaySOP, you can still use the marker points and switch the entity to points. The method would need to stay on project rays, and since I want to test into a specific direction, I turn this direction from normal to vector and make it 1 in X. The node needs something to collide with. In this case, it should collide with itself, so we connect the same stream into the second input. And finally, we have a bunch of toggles to change the behavior of this node. The node has the same issue with the self-collision, but we have a setting to hit the farthest surface instead of the first collision. The node probably uses intersect all under the hood. We can generate a group from this node that will include all the hit locations, and now we could use that again to color the primitives. There's nothing wrong here. Keep in mind, every single node is nothing else than a piece of coding with a UI made by SideFX developers to fill a specific need to do a certain task. Use whatever you are comfortable with. The result is what matters in the end. The HIP file is now available for Patreons and will switch to public after 1 week. I see you next time. Cheers.